A very warm good morning to everyone present over here. I, Daneshwari Sanjeev Dumale of Grade 10, welcoming all the dignitaries and all my dear students for this auspicious occasion. So, as you all know, we are celebrating Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, and this is a very, very special occasion for all of us, and we are all going to join our hands to make this function a grand success.
निरिगे नई दिली समुद्र के तेरे श्रृंगारा समुद्र के तेरे श्रृंगारा निरिगे नई दिलिए श्रृंगारा निरिगे नई दिलिए श्रृंगारा नारिगे गुणवे श्रृंगारा नारिगे गुणवे गगनके चंद्रमने श्रृंगारा गगनके चंद्रमने श्रृंगारा निरिगे नई दिलिए श्रृंगारा निरिगे नई दिलिए श्रृंगारा नम्म कूडल संगन शरणर नम्म कूडल संगन शरणर नोसलिगे विभूतिये श्रृंगारा नोसलिगे विभूतिये श्रृंगारा निरिगे नई दिलिए श्रृंगारा निरिगे नई दिलिए श्रृंगारा समुद्र के तेरे श्रृंगारा समुद्र के तेरे श्रृंगारा निरिगे नई दिलिए श्रृंगारा निरिगे नई दिलिए निरिगे नई दिलिए निरिगे नई दिलिए
श्रृंगारा ईच एंड एवरीवन प्रेजेंट ओवर हियर स्टार शाइन एट नाइट सम स्टार्स शाइन एट डे लाइट ब्राइट इट्स अवर प्लेजर टू वेलकम सच वंस अ स्टार सर संजीव अंगी पोस्टमास्टर ऑफ अंगी is influence, not authority. With this quote, I would like to welcome Sir Rohit Kotiwali, Postmaster Sangat. And heartily would like to welcome Sir Malikarjun Kaur, Postmaster Assistant Sangat. I would like to welcome Sir Kishore Srikande, Postman Angli. Sir Uvekma Kodar, we celebrate your leadership and you keep on influencing us. We welcome you, ma'am. He who put his soul and heart in uplifting others attains destiny. Yes, I welcome all the dignitaries on this stage. Last but not the least, I sincerely welcome all my teachers and my dear friends. Once again, I welcome everyone to this function of Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. Thank you. Now, I would like to call Varsha of Grade 9 to let us know about the history of the postal cards.
Good morning, everyone. I am Varsha from 9. I would like to speak about origin of postal cards. A postal cards are postal stationery with an imprinted stamp or indicium signifying the prepayment of postage. They are sold by postal authorities. On January 26, 1869, Dr. Emanuel Hermann of Austria described the advantages of correspondence karte. By October 1, 1869, the world's first postal card was produced by Austria-Hungary. They thought on TV. By the end of 1789, Great Britain, Finland, Switzerland, and Württemberg joined the countries issuing postal cards. In the United States, they were first produced in 1873. Some of the forms taken by postal cards include the regular single card, which may be commemorative or definitive, attached message, reply cards, airmail postal cards, and official postal cards used for official government business with a penalty for private use. Postcards or postal cards provided a way for the general public to keep in touch with their friends and family and required letter writing. Anytime there was a major event, a postcard photographer was there to document it, including celebrations, disasters, political moments, and even wars. Thank you.
Thank you, Varsha. Now I would like to call Soumya of grade 9 to let us know about something, the insignificance of postal cards and how does it works in the modern India.
A postcard is a piece of thick paper or thin cardboard, typically rectangular, intended for writing and mailing without an envelope. Postcard is usually printed and sold by a private company, individual or organization. A postal card is issued by the relevant postal authority. Cards with a message have been created and posted by individuals since the beginning of postal services. When traveling, it is easy to lose contact with the people you would usually spend a lot of time with, and that's entirely normal. Exploring new places, making new friends and learning new things is a part of the fun. Disengaging from your social media newsfeed is a good way to immerse yourself in your new adventures. But it doesn't mean that you have to avoid all forms of communication. Postcards are a fun way to keep touch with your family and friends. After fun while sending letters, the friend internationally is never really knowing when they will be reaching. So it's a bit of a surprise for everyone involved when these recipients and then in their mailboxes. A production of a postcard blossomed in the late 19th and earlier 20th centuries, and it was an easy and a quick way for individuals to communicate. They become extremely popular those days. Thank you.
Postcards could be dated back to the Victorian era in the UK. It was the first time that brightly colored coupons were sent and received to share the joy of special occasions, travel destinations, and precious memories. However, there has been a steady decline in the sales of postcards. Predominantly, due to the rise of social media and portable technology, these platforms have led to instant sharing and convenience for postcard consumers. Social media has overtaken this industry. The beauty of postcards is that they do not demand much of the reader and have a way of strengthening bonds and disarming people. Postcard sales peaked in 1990s. Sales started falling in the early 20s when the internet gained popularity and private couriers, which were largely unregulated, mushroomed everywhere. The postcard commands a certain sense of timelessness. It requires a precise, direct and honest form of writing, whether you are writing a personal or a political message. For decades, the postcard has had different uses for different people, carrying everything from simple message to poems, quotes, sketches, recipes, and childhood memories. There are people in everyone's life who deserve more than an email. These days, people who receive postcards are pleasantly surprised. The DMs are disposable. Postcards are forever. There is a human element in postcard that is hard to ignore. The intention was also to urge people to communicate their feelings by putting pen on paper. People have forgotten how to write by hand. If you can write succinctly on Twitter, you might as well write succinctly on postcard. Postcard is also about art of writing a short story. Letter writing might be a lost art, but not everyone is accepting the fault. BTS, the Grammy-nominated K-pop sensation, recently surprised their fans world over, officially known as ARMY, with handwritten postcards. And closer home in Chennai, Latha Menon, a filmmaker and storyteller, is trying to revive the lost art through her recent project. This year has been introspective. We have all come to realize the importance of community and communication. Initially, during pandemic, everyone went into their shells. But now everybody knows that it is important to share. When there is a heartbreaker that is reaching you with a handwritten note, there is nothing more beautiful. Thank you. I heartily welcome you, Manu Amal.
Postcard.
Thank you, Varsha, Sakshi and Soumya to make us aware about the postal cards. Now I request Sandeep Amdi sir to inspire us with their words. Please, sir.
Yep. Say good morning. ಸರ್ ಮಂತು ಮೈಸೂರು ಮಂತು
ಹಾಗೂ ನನ್ನ ಮತ್ತು ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳೇ ಹಾಗೂ ಇನ್ನಿತರ ನನ್ನ ಶಿಕ್ಷಕರೇ ಇವತ್ತಿನ ದಿನ ನಿಮಗೆಲ್ಲ ಗೊತ್ತಿರುವಂತೆ ಆಜಾದ್ ಕಾ ಮಹೋತ್ಸವ ಅಂಗವಾಗಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಪೋಸ್ಟಲ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವತಿಯಿಂದ ಒಂದು ಲೆಟರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಂಪೇನ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾಂಪೇನ್ ಅನ್ನು ಹಮ್ಮಿಕೊಳ್ಳಲಾಗಿದ್ದು ನಿಮಗೆಲ್ಲ ಗೊತ್ತಿರುವಂತೆ ವಿಷಯದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಟಾಪಿಕ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ನೀವು ವಿಷಯವನ್ನು ಪತ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಂಡಿಸಿದ್ದೀರಾ ಮತ್ತು
letter writing is there in the exam to get marks. Yes, for the leave letter or how you celebrate your birthday, have money to go for a picnic, tell your friends how you are staying at your hostel, especially 10th standard, higher than masses, edit the letters, purchase letters, request, formal, informal. You have seen a letter writing in the paper. But today it is quite different from your writing a letter in the postcard. I can understand a card which is very small. It's not 1/4 of a page. You can write it either vertical or you can write it either horizontal. Depends on the content what you write. And before writing a letter, your content has to be measured and kept ready. This is why postcard writing is quite different. You cannot go on writing as much as you can as it is written in a paper. Your content has been measured, how many words, how many paragraphs, one or two, which should be too small, with one or two statements. The second paragraph can be with four or five statements, not more. And it has to be completed, whatever you want to express your ideas in. So these postcard letters to be written is very specific. Too specific, you have to reach to the point after the mark in the given space. It's a difficult part. Somebody asked me to speak in a very short note explaining about the postcard writing. It's very difficult. I would like to speak at least 20 to 25 statements on this. But they say that you have to speak only 2 to 3 statements and you should be out. I can understand students, the most difficult task what you have done is writing a postcard. I know you have taken the help of your parents, either yourself, brothers or sisters, your teachers. You must have written 2 or 3 times on a piece of paper, practiced it and then written it up. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
See, this is called as practice. We didn't tell you to do the homework of writing 2 times in a playbook and in a classwork. The postcard has become your playbook.
Yes, ma'am.
And that playbook, instead of getting marks, you are directly posting it to the Prime Minister. A happy feeling and a proud feeling. We don't know, we are not sure. Will you get a reply from the Prime Minister or yes? We are not sure. But the thought is we have to do our duty. With lot of happy feelings of every word, your feelings are there. We only pray that may all these letters reach to the department in a proper way. There may be almost lakhs of people to sit and segregate the letters. It's not going to be an easy task. If one Prime Minister's letter comes to the school saying that we have received the letters from the students of KV Basaprabhu Kore School, it reaches every child. Yes? So we wait to get a letter from the PM office to the school. Never be jealous that it is coming to the school and not to me. But you should feel happy that it is only because you all wrote a letter, we may receive a letter. As we receive a letter, we will put it down to you. Okay? Now, this was a practice for you all to know what happened before independence, the post-independence period, how the people used to share their thoughts, their views, in a very small postcard, in a very specific way, direct way. Smaller than this was telegraph. The more you write the words, the more you have to pay. Lesser words, less payment. So they used to express if there is any sad demise or a child being born, the telegram was given. That used to go, reach very fast. Postcard used to take a little time, similar to the inland letters. Inland letters are big. A thin piece of paper, which is having two pages, where you can complete writing in detail. Postcard, a very simple way, which is open for everyone. Anybody can read it in the house. If it is dropped, a letter is dropped, anyone can read. Inland is a packed letter. So the next phase for you all, if you have any secret to write to your friends, to your relatives, to your cousins, you can write it in an inland letter. Try writing and posting it. You will understand why letter is being included as a compulsory part in the examination. This day, we really feel proud as a student to write a letter to Prime Minister on this day of Azadi Ka Mahotsav. 75 years, why? We are stepping on to the 75th Independence Day, which comes on August 15, 22. We can't celebrate on a single day. So it's a long way of celebration every month. One of the other celebrations are called off. Keep this patriotic spirit among you all. I thank the students who have read about the details about postcards, how it has been coming into the formation. We will have a quiz later, class-wise, where we will inculcate this into more detail to learn. Not only writing a letter and dropping it. The most important part is dropping the letter into the post box, which you have seen in your KG classes. What is a post box? And who are the professional people? Who drops the letter in the, who collects the letters from the post box?
Postman.
Who is there here today? Who is there? Who is in the uniform? You can see Shrikanth sir. Yes? So it's his duty to collect all the letters and go and drop to every house. They are the postal department officers who sit there and segregate, who stamp it, who know which area the letters have to go. Only those areas the postman, different postmen will be sent. As per the area wise. Ankli being small, Alon Shrikanth manages. So we need to know what to work, how they get this post. They are all class 1 employees under the central government scheme. Post office. is a central government department. It is managed by Delhi, not by the state. It is not by Karnataka. It is managed from the center. To get a job is really very difficult. They have to write exams. With a good salary package, you get the job. Not only engineers and doctors are paid more, but there are more paid packages where you can be the government officers. We have the honor today to have the postal department people with us. I really take this privilege to thank them on behalf of our school to take their valuable time from their busy schedule and be among us so that you all learn. You know the value of their work. You know the value of writing the letter, so difficult it is. When it is posted, where it goes, how it reaches back to the person is the tracking system which you need to find. Postal department has become digital now. It can track the letter where it reaches and when it reaches. So no person can deny my letter has not reached. There is no false note. I request every student to see that you have an account in your post office nearby. Every child can have your personal account where you can keep your savings. Even if you have 2 rupees, 20 rupees, you can save it in that account. Try getting it. We will call the officers again to let you all know how the account is to be opened, how you have to go and save the money. Do you want it?
Yes, ma'am.
Your own account?
Yes,
ma'am. Yes. We will request the teachers to see that the department is called again so that they will guide us in the near future. Thank you for having the patience of writing and listening to the teacher. I thank the control team, Chetna and Irana. To Chetna, mainly because she is our lead role to have this function to coming up to her success. Thank you, Chetna. Thank you to all the parents who have helped you all to write the letter. Given time to write, let the homework be kept aside. First write the letter. First do the homework, let us write the letter. Later your parents are not safe. So we thank every parent, which you will give the thanks to them. And thank you everyone. Please keep this writing in progress. You can collect stamps from various countries. You have pen friends. Whenever you write a letter to somebody whom you don't know, you have not seen, they are called as pen friends. You can have them in your list. Keep drawing. Know how India has progressed from the postal to the digitalization. Facebook, WhatsApp are all not Indian. They are outside. So we need to support the Indian system, which is with post, BSNL network. Maybe many schemes are there with government. Let us all support them. Thank you, teachers, to motivate the students to write letters. Thank you, the team, for a nice vachana. Thank you, photographers, to be with us, keeping updated on the Facebook. We need you all to update on the post now. Thank you for the whole team.
रखते हैं दम, साथ अगर है तो काफी है हम। निर्भर है खुद पे हम रखते हैं दम, जोड़ेंगे ना बापू कभी तेरा रास्ता। इस मिट्टी से ही पैदा हुए, इस मिट्टी